That's cool, Keisha. You just moved into Texas. That's cool. Yeah, I'm here. Okay, so let's go over this machine here in just a second. Hi, guys. Thanks for joining the stream. I'm going to, you know, say hi to you guys, like GG, Brandon, Keisha, Tyler Games. What's going on? Robert made it. Hey, thanks, Robert. Said hi, Jaden, Brandon, Crestwood, Wood Rocks. Shout out. And I know there's some more people out there. Feel free to chat. It's pretty much a safe place. We can kind of talk. All right, so let me zoom out so we can take a look at this washer. Actually, let me go back in. Let me just make sure I can see the serial number. Okay, I can see it. Model and serial number. All right. So I'm gonna do the recording here in just a second, and then let me turn off the air conditioner. Friday, it's after work. It's been a long week, so this will be nice to kind of wind things down. All right, so let's talk about this washer. I'm going to hit record one second. Give me one sec, guys. Okay, I'm going to start the recording. Hi, my name is Kirk Rivas with Appliance Associates. Today we have a Sears Kenmore washer, model number 110-224-42100. I can barely read that. It's so small. And somebody can... If they can, they can check what year this thing was made. You can probably check by the serial number. So let's take a look at the control panel. So we'll start on the far left. It looks pretty simple and basic. Hopefully we got, I can barely see the screen, but it looks like it's okay. It looks like it's focused. So on the far left, you have the water level. And that's going to be like small. You got the, like in between small and medium. A couple of clicks, it's very rough, but it's very, you know, let you know where you're at, which is nice. So at the 9 o'clock position, you have the small load. Between 9 and 12, you have the I guess in between small and medium, and the medium's at 12 o'clock, and then 1 o'clock is doesn't say anything, but it's in between medium and large. And at the 3 o'clock position, you have the large load. So that's the one button on the left. Now, usually you have some other buttons next to that, but if you scroll over to the right of that, and you have nothing until you get to the timer. So usually what we have there in between these two buttons are going to be the water temperature. So you don't have water temperature on the console, but it is built into the timer. So let's see how that works. So let's say you want to do a heavy duty load and you want to wash in hot water. Make sure we're focused. Yeah, it looks pretty good. So the heavy duty loads, it's at the like around the 9 o'clock position up to I guess all the way down to the 3 o'clock position. It goes all the way around that. That should be pretty neat to see. But if you start off right at 9 o'clock, it says 14, so that's gonna be like a 14-minute agitation. And it says super. I guess that would be the soil. And underneath that, it says hot/cold, which means that's going to be your hot temperature and your cold rinse. Now, if you turn it, that's the 14. So if you click it over to the 12, that's going to be around like the 9:30 position. It says regular. It's going to be, so you're still under heavy duty, but it's going to be regular soil, warm on the temperature. So instead of hot, it's going to be warm, and the rinse is going to be cold. Now, if you want to do a cold wash with a cold rinse, you turn it up to about the, you know, 10, 11 o'clock position, and the number is number 6, which means it's going to be like a 6-minute agitation, I believe, and that's going to be your cold wash and cold rinse. So instead of having a separate button or a knob for temperature, you're going to have only, it's going to be built into the timer. A little bit more complicated timer, I guess, because it has more contacts in it. So, just a little bit different design. And so on, that's the left side of that timer. It's heavy duty. And then what we have on the right, down here, starting off around the 4 o'clock position, between 3 and 4 o'clock position, you have permanent press. You have the same principle. So, like at the very start of that cycle, it's going to say 10, which will be a 10-minute agitation. It's going to, and it's super soil, I believe. And it's going to be the hot wash with the cold rinse. And if you go down to the 8-minute agitation, it's going to be a warm wash with the cold rinse. And if you click a little bit more, it's going to make those click noises. Okay, so that's 10. Click to the 8. Click to the 6. That's going to be your short wash, cold wash with the cold rinse. And that's all you have. You just have basically two cycles. And down here it says heavy duty, super capacity. So this is probably a 3.0 cubic foot. Usually 3 cubic foot, super capacity means 3 cubic foot. And the agitator is a one-piece agitator. I think there's a special name for this, but we don't know. I don't know what to call it. It does not have a fabric dispenser, in the agitator. So it's just a flat top. I guess it was a stripped-down model. And also, you don't have any place for the whatchamacallit, the bleach. It does have the porcelain tub. Pretty simple. And I guess I need to get this thing rigged up so we can start washing. Here we go. All right, so let me, I'm gonna kind of do something real quick. I'm gonna switch it over here. Go ahead and go. Let's go in. And while I work on the machine, oh, maybe the lid switch. Hopefully that works. If not, I can mess with it during the washing. Okay. This guy's gonna sit here. Now, what this guy is, it's a toy crab. I put him on the edge of the tub. He's like a, vibration sensor. So if he vibrates too much, he'll fall in. He won't get hurt though, because it's hard plastic. So unlike the previous washer, this washer is a direct drive, not belt driven. It looks like it's probably about 15 years old. Maybe younger, but it's probably, it's an entry level washer. This is probably the washer that the, you know, this washer is probably bolted to the sales floor. It was a price point washer, which means that it brought people into the store, and the if the sales reps sold too many of them, they pretty much lost their job. So that's the way kind of things took place, you know, on this type of thing. Is we call that when they bolt a washer to the floor. It's on the sales floor, but it's not there to sell. It's just bring people in, and you step them up to a nicer machine. I think there's some issues with that legally, but it does happen. I don't know if it's still currently happening today, but you never know. Let's see. All right, so we turned that to the heavy duty cycle. It's going to be hot with a cold rinse. I turned off the water valve because we do have a small leak, but it's not in the water hose. I think it's in the pump or the tub or somewhere like that, because there is water on the floor from when we tested it earlier. So I'm going to turn both valves on. Okay, I'm going to start it right here. We got enough light. Yeah, you know, I was thinking about the crab. I don't know if I can make it the mascot or not. I don't want the toy company to call me up and say, stop doing this to my crab. So I don't know. I may feature it a couple more times and then pull it off. But I don't know. I don't want to get my videos flagged for having somebody else's toy in my video, you know. So Rose asked me if this is your store. It's a family store. Belongs to my father. And it's his store. I just work here. Hey, Keisha, how are you? So there's a crab in the video because I don't know. I like this crab a whole lot. I saw it at the toy store. And I took my kids there one day. And, you know, I saw it. I like it a lot. We used to bring these crabs back from when we went to the coast. And we try to get them to live a while. And they usually do. They usually stay with us for a couple months. And then they, you know, they'll die off. But they're fun. We, you know, give them special food, give them a little home, and just kind of watch them. They're pretty neat. That's crazy. Somebody said that there's even somebody said that they're even lower models than this. And he said one cycle and one load size. That's crazy. I never seen one like that. I'll keep an eye out for that. Maybe that was the one that was bolted to the floor. Somebody asked what I have at the house. I do have a SpeedClean top load washer. I did have an Electrolux washer for a very long time. And then we just swapped over to the SpeedClean. I have currently the TC Classic. Seems to be a good washer. My wife likes it, but I do want to put the TR series in when I get a chance. I agree with you, Jerry. I think, you know, insanely basic, like the one that they were talking about with the one cycle with one water level, but it got the job done, and that's really all you need. so the hose clamp is floating around in there, as Robert has pointed out. I need to talk to my delivery guys and find out why that wasn't installed. It's from a new washing machine, so I guess they just decided not to use it. I don't know. It did go down, guys. It got sucked down. That's cool. Yeah, I'm thinking that the hose clamp fell in because, of course, we delivered the new washing machine, and this is the hallway, so I guess the washer we delivered, it fell off or something. So a lot of times they gather trash and from the previous delivery and throw it into the washing machine, and so I think that's what happened. Just whatever, the stuff they didn't use just got tossed in, and I didn't notice it. What's pretty cool is that clamp is floating, but because of the rotation of the clothes, it's being sucked down. It will get sucked down here in a second, I'm sure. So there's for those that are need to understand what's taking place, the hose clamp is plastic, and it attaches to the back of the washing machine. And it kind of holds your drain hose in place to keep it from moving around when you're taking your washer from one place to another. It kind of keeps it locked in. And so when you install the washing machine, sometimes that clamp will pull away from the back of the washer and it falls onto the floor. And that's apparently what happened. You usually don't need it in an installation at the customer's house, but they should have left it on. So when they did move the washer again, when they move it, then you will be able to, clamp the hose onto the back of the washer. And so that clamp was thrown in here and kind of left behind, and I didn't see it. And so now it's just floating around in there. I don't want to reach in and pull it out, because that's not safe. You don't want to do that. Even though nobody's going to get hurt, I just don't want to show people that it's okay to put your hand in there, because it's really not. It's never okay to put your hand inside of a washing machine when it's operating, just to be on the safe side, guys. So if I wanted to pull that out, I wanted to you stop the machine, then you can do what you want and you start your machine again. But in this case, I don't want to stop the machine. I just want to let it fly. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, guys, thanks for watching. I still have to do a couple more things at work, but I have to start packing this stuff up right now. So, Ryan, thanks for hanging in there. Thank you, Jerry. Gigi, thanks for stopping by. Caesar, thanks, man. Cammy Cams, nice to see hear from you again. And Robert already said goodbye, so that's okay. Caesar, I think that's about it right now. Anyway, guys, you have a good evening. I'm not sure what we're going to do tomorrow. I may have to do some other stuff after work. But I may keep this washer here a little bit longer. It is leaking water. Yeah, it had a pretty good leak back here, so I'm not sure what's happening. Yeah, there's water everywhere, so to be careful. I'm going to go ahead and turn off the water. Pretty sure it's only when it's spinning or draining or something. It's dripping. Probably some kind of hole. Plug it. So I don't know. Maybe we won't do anything with this washer. I think I just want to probably get this thing and put it outside and go to the next one. I think we have that almond one. We'll get that one checked out probably Monday or Tuesday. And there's a couple other ones out there too. So anyway, guys, thanks for watching. Take care. And we'll see you next time. And the stream still goes on. Tell you what, I'm going to... I need to cut this thing down so it's pretty much done.